If you have Slido for Microsoft PowerPoint and Slido for Microsoft Teams, you can use them both together. So let's see how you can do this in three simple steps. Step one is to add Slido to your PowerPoint. Once you have downloaded and installed Slido for PowerPoint, you'll see it in the taskbar and you click that Slido button and you'll get the Slido sidebar right here. You will need to log in to Slido first, but I've already done that. And we're going to create a new Slido by clicking on this green button. Then we can see our list of interactions here, all the different poll types. So let's add our first interaction into the slide deck. We're going to go for an open text poll. So we click on that and we can ask our question, what is giving you energy today? And I'm happy for people to submit multiple answers and for them to show their names. You can untick this if you want. And we can decide here if we want to show the results or not. So if you turn the toggle off, the results will not show during the presentation. But if you turn the toggle on, you can decide from here if you want the results to show immediately or once you've clicked. So let's let them show immediately. I'm happy with everything here, and I'm going to click Add to Presentation. And then this is just a placeholder slide. Once the presentation is live, then this will be a Slido poll that will activate automatically once we get to it. It's going to look different. If I want to edit the poll or anything, I can do it here in the three-dot menu, but I'm happy and I'm going to add a new interaction by clicking this button. So let's go for our audience Q&A next. It's at the bottom here. We just click audience Q&A and we can just drag it just like a normal slide to where it needs to be. Again, this is just the placeholder slide. It will look different once we are presenting and the Slido questions that are coming in from participants will be showing here. And the next step is to add Slido to Teams. So go to your Teams meeting and you will see the apps button on the top here. So click on that and you can search for or find Slido right there and click it. Click on that save button and you'll need to log in at first. I've already done that. And then you'll see the list of Slidos that you've created. And we want to connect the same Slido that we've added to the presentation. So we click on that. And here we go. We can see the poll and the Q&A that we've already added. So this is everything we need to do here. Slido is added to the presentation and to the Teams meeting call. Then the final step, share your screen and show the PowerPoint presentation. So the host view is on the left here. They click on share and select the PowerPoint. And in the Slido sidebar, they click that green present button, start presenting their slides. Once they click onto a Slido poll, it will activate and the participants will get a red dot notification. And they click on that Slido or they'll get a notification in the chat as well that a poll is active. And they can type in their response. And you can see responses from other participants coming in, just like that on the screen, until the host clicks on to the next slides. And these are just the normal PowerPoint slides until they click through and get to the Q&A. And the next one is the Slido interactive Q&A wall. And participants can put in their questions in the sidebar in Teams, like you can see in this participant view on the right. They can decide if they want to be anonymous or ask the question with their name and send the question. And on the host side, they can easily manage the questions by simply hovering over each one and clicking the highlight button so it sticks to the top, clicking the tick button when it's answered to mark it as answered. And that's how simple it is. Happy Slidoing!